Greetings. This is the next video examining and answering some questions from Islam, Part 3. In Video 1 of this series, I laid out the 12 points of the message from the Islamic poster. Let's get on to Point 3. If possible, I'll fit 4 in as well. If Jesus is God, then who is the Father? Is he also God? As I implied in Part 2, in order to understand the Christian answer, you must use Christian definitions. You cannot use Islam's definitions and hope to have any chance of learning the truth. I recommend you watch my video series about the Trinity. But remember when Jesus said there were teachings you could not bear without the Holy Spirit? John 16:12, I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all truth. Well, the Trinity is one of those truths you cannot truly grasp without the Holy Spirit. But I still recommend you watch my video series about the Trinity. So when you hear the word God and your mind imagines a picture of a being of pure light, your imagination is deriving its image from the biblical description of God the Father. 1 John 1:5. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. Revelation 21:23, and the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it. For the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. Notice that last sentence, and the Lamb is the light thereof. It is statements like this which directly imply that Jesus is God. It is such revelation by the apostles from the Holy Spirit which revealed the Trinity. So to even begin to hope to understand the answer to point 3, you must understand the message of the prophets and the apostles. And then you must welcome the Holy Spirit into your heart to explain it to you. But he only comes into the hearts of those who accept and honor the Son of God. But we see in the Word of God that the Son of God is one with God. In fact, the Son of God said that he was one with God. John 10:30, I and my Father are one. Over and over, Jesus made statements that irrefutably only make sense if said by someone who thought they were equal with God. John 10:7, Then said Jesus unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. John 10:9, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and he shall go in and out and find pasture. O Mohammedan, Jesus spoke with authority and said things Mohammed would not dare utter, because Jesus is one with God. And I could easily fill many hours of video with the words of the Son of God, but that would not be a direct answer to the question of point 3. John 10:15, As the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Even so I know. How can any man claim to know God as well as God knows him? There are only two rational answers. John 10:18, No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. I have the power to raise myself from the dead. How can any man claim to be able to raise himself from the dead? There are only two rational answers. If you cannot figure out the two answers, let me know. Perhaps it is worth a video. Even if you only respected Jesus as a prophet, these words reveal to open eyes that Jesus talks and behaves like God. If Jesus is God, then who is the Father? Is he also God? The first element of answering the question is to understand that even if Jesus is God, that does not mean Jesus' physical body or even his incorporeal spirit is all of God. In fact, in the previous video of this series, Jesus declares that God the Father remained in heaven while Jesus was dead. Thus, Jesus could ascend to his Father still in heaven. John 20:17, Yeshua said to her, "Don't cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to join my Father. And go join my brothers and say to them that I ascend to join my Father and your Father, my God and your God." And even while reading this whole verse, I know that Mohammedans will only see five words, "my God and your God." Pray against the demonic retardation that Islam causes. Pray against the demons that are dragging those called Muslims to hell. If Jesus is God, then who is the Father? Is he also God? Within the Trinity, God the Father is the clear and decided leader of the hierarchy. This is why Jesus, while submitting to be in the flesh, called God the Father, my God. There is no doubt that God the Father is the mental model image Christians and Jews all worship and revere. But to Christians, the evidence that Jesus is also God is irrefutable and overwhelming. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. Along with the Trinity, it is clear that the knowledge that Jesus is God is a truth men could not bear without the Holy Spirit. I really encourage you to watch my other videos proving that Jesus is God by his fulfillment of the message of the prophets. If Jesus is God, then who is the Father? Is he also God? The Father exhibits leadership of the Trinity. Jesus defers to the Father. Jesus honors the Father. Jesus glorifies the Father. Jesus even submits to the Father. And now Jesus sits at the right hand of the Father. And God the Father has restored to Jesus the glory that Jesus shared with God before creation. John 17:5, "Now glorify me, my Father, in union with yourself, in that glory which I had in union with you before the universe was." God the Father is certainly God. And Lord Jesus is certainly God. And the Holy Spirit is certainly God. And when honest, thoughtful, God-fearing men considered the revelation of God, the Holy Spirit showed them the Trinity. If Jesus is God, then who is the Father? Is he also God? As I've said, you cannot answer these questions without understanding Christian definitions. But my Christian answer has been fully supported by God's Word, the Torah, and the Injil. There is no question Mohammedans may ask that God does not have an answer for. So the summary answer is that God the Father is clearly God. Even at the same time that Jesus is God, divine and eternal, and the Holy Spirit is God, divine and eternal. though I haven't proved that in this particular video. Who is the Father? If you cannot now understand some of the Christian proof who God the Father is, you need to watch this video again. And please do. It is free and it is true. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.